All right, here we are. Supposedly. Yeah. Okay. We're making some sound. All right. So, let's see what we can do about making a video. And just sit here and have a talkity talk. So, what's been going on in life? Well, we can have a heart-to-heart just conversation. What's on the heart, man? So, let's just relax and let the blood run flow freely. Disperse all the energies. Now, realize everything is a universal test to see how much we're going to maintain our balance so that we can obtain keeping these bodies that we presently have. Sure, we're going to go off the deep end every now and then, but the goal is to achieve a relaxed balance, an eternal balance. Right, raising those repressed emotions that are sunk to the bottom of the ocean soul. So when we're examining someone's heart, you know, sometimes our first reaction is one of no trust, a one of no appreciation. But if you realize that the universe is just testing us, regardless of who says what or who does what, the universe is ultimately looking for our appreciation, although there are two sides of the coin. So in our critical reviews of personalities and people and reactions, even though we might have a negative reaction at first, we should swing back over to the same quality of rhythm on the positive side. But we also have the capability to neutralize rhythm with the law of polarity. This is where balance comes in. This is where forgiveness and compassion comes in. This is where realizing that people are pupils no matter what, and they are in a growth process. And so the main thing is just to be who we are, but yet realize that, you know, we're on the road to improvement, no matter what our situation of in life is. So, no matter what people say, all their things that they got to go through, you know, ultimately, international peace treaties are the ultimate goal for each one of us human beings that are looking to achieve capstone skills. Just remember the dude Jesus. Just keep in mind I called him a dude. This dude Jesus was just an example showing us that living in the present body that we have is possible. It just takes a little time to teach old dogs new tricks. When you're teaching an old dog new tricks, it's best to use some different food than what he's used to eating. You give him some of that new food that he's like, wow, let me jump on the table for that. Next thing you know, you can teach that dog to jump on chairs. If you can teach a dog to jump on chairs, you can sure as hell teach a circus fucking cat to jump on chairs too. About 3 or 4 of them at a time, with no cage on the stage, and maintain peace between facing the animal and your magnum opus of alchemy for all you steens out there who know a little something. Even though it's the universe who checks the heart to see if you're just using the language or not, or are you actually facing your animal and appointing your ego animal to die once and for all? Irregardless of where you are on the planet. Because ultimately, it's the universe who decides what's going to happen to each and every one of us. According to the trust that we have developed with Mama and Dada. If you ever listened to your old proverbs and kept them on your lips ready to speak, you'd realize that if you honor your mother and your father, both in the physical and the spiritual world, you shall live a long and prosperous life, and that is the key to eternity. Don't toss your mother away. If you toss your mother away, you're going to find a cold hell winter. Because you're going to lock yourself up in the house while Mama's outside in the cold all by herself needing some warmth. If you honor your mother, you're going to take care of her. And your father, you're going to take care of him. Honor. Same thing with Mother Nature. It ain't no different. Father Cosmos, if you honor Mother Nature when it's winter time and you get out there outside the house and spend time with Mama out in the cold and build an outdoor rocket stove so you can heat cold Mama up, you'll find that the universe will actually tilt the earth up and down and side to side and do whatever it takes to get some more warmth into your area where you're at. And we can all share the warmth. Or better yet, we can all actually kind of like bring in some suns from different spheres for the angle that you need. Oh yeah, it's possible to have more than one sun in our atmospheric area. Y'all just never probably thought about that. That's why I'm here as the motivational speaker, shaman, Old Testament, New Testament prophet, whatever you call it, getting down with the clown of the elite. So you can smell some feet, and they're beautiful. So, the universe has all kinds of tests ready for you, and that includes the test of leaning in trust in your share of the corporate certificate application bond ready to access as you see fit. Remember, you write your own life. No matter what's going on around you, the universe will always bring everybody around to bow to the philosopher's stone and the straight shooting marble man's ideas that are predominant toward the area of love, no matter where you are on the earth. Don't forget that. Keep it warm, because we're going to listen to a little bit of Zero the Hero. What's that? Black Sabbath. Keep it warm. Keep it warm. Keep it warm, honey, warm for your man. forget pretty, pretty woman, you're mine. You're coming home, baby. Keep it warm. So when we talk on the phone. Ooh, there it is. Keep it warm. There it is. I can hear it, but, you know. I'm just going to sing along with it. You can just listen. A sweet brown bone jail and fight. What was it that you did last night? Looked at crazy and made me mind. It was lit up with milk in your eyes. Ooh, feeling me. Morning, I was born free. I can't leave you alone. I'll be coming home. I says, keep it warm. Right. Place by your side. Don't forget it. Don't take away your magic ride. Keep it warm when we talk on the phone. Don't forget, pretty, pretty woman, your man is coming home. Baby, jumping around. Maybe that's a little down. Maybe half and half. Know that love is, but I still like it fast. Learning fine. Learning for the very last time. Since I made it, I can't leave for long. Maybe morning I'm coming home. And I said, keep it warm, rat. A place by your side. Don't worry, it's gonna take away a magic ride. Keep it warm when we talk on the phone. Don't forget, pretty, pretty woman, your man. Your man will be home. Time for some Tony Iommi. Well, we'll just do it like this for now. I watched me some Sebastian Bach videos, man. That dude got it going on with his Willie Nelson self. Shed a tear on them mamas. Woo! Make them women shed a tear with that voice. Starting off in them low registers and bringing it up an octave, and those women go down for the clown count. Of course, it's always the women who like to share their emotions, ain't it? Shed a little tear for her brother, so he can help that male get in touch with his female side. That need to roam. I'll be coming home. Ooh, I need to smell. I need to know what is over each hill. Ooh, I'm a different man. I understand. Since I met you, I can't leave you alone. No, I'll be coming home, she said. Keep it warm, right. A place by your side. Don't forget, it's gonna take away our goal and our ride. Keep it warm, so when we talk on the phone, don't forget, you're gonna take away our dope. do 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 do. Good night, sweetheart. It's time to go. Do 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 do. Magical ride. Keep it warm. So when we talk on the phone, don't forget pretty, pretty woman. Your man's coming home. Your man's coming home. Don't forget, pretty, pretty woman, your man. Your man. Coming home. Don't forget, pretty, pretty woman. 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 There we are. I hope that patched everything up that might have been falling off in the block, irregardless of who says what and who posts what. I hope you're able to get down with your clown so you can do some food banking. Dope doodle, dope doodle, dope doodle, dope do. Good night, sweetheart. It's time to blow. Dun, 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 dun. Good night, sweetheart. It's, you know what I'm saying? Check out what we got here free on Craigslist. All kinds of good stuff for free. Just remember, man, if you can endure through the coldness of mama, both in relationship, as in a real mama, and Mother Nature's cold, it's all the same thing, just a different level. Just a different level of the pyramid if you understand how to polish your philosopher's stone. Remember, YouTube has brought Freemasonry and Illuminati into the big realms, man. Freemasonry and the Illuminati is becoming popular. The ancient secrets, the ancient knowledge is becoming more public, more and more. So that gives us more of a foundation to relax upon when our female side likes to impulsively, instinctually protect. Protect and lash out in protection while Father Bear sits around and thinks. Mama Bear says, ain't no time to think. I'm getting down with the clown right to hell now. I'll do my thinking later. I'll analyze everything that needs to be analyzed later. Then I'll make my adjustments. As for right now, I'm doing what it takes to get down with an impulse move right now as we do five steps on our Elliott wave. You know, understand, if you understand the 4X market, you'll get down with your paper debt note clown. But, you know, that all takes an education. It takes about 6 years, like I've always been preaching, to learn how to type in the YouTube search, Solutions in Commerce, and listen to an aged, white-haired man introduce you to the real laws of the universe. And remember that the higher laws supersede the lower legal codes. If you know how to do it. And that takes practice. So there's no use getting all, you know, well, you do what you want to do. You just let out what you need to let out so you can start dealing with that, those, you know, repressed emotions, you know. Find a tear to shed. Find a little bit of tear to shed, you know. Ain't nothing wrong with shedding a little bit of tear. In fact, that's good to shed a little tear, you know. Get on that camera and put on that microphone. If you're recording some music, shed some real tears while you're singing songs, brother. You'd be surprised at the resonance that happens. The resonance, frequency that happens with all those around you while you listen to it. You'd be surprised. I remember I did that once, and man, it sounds so good, but the universe decided not to save my recording. So I said, all right, universe, it's on the hard disk. We'll retrieve it later in life. So, but, you know, like the good black preacher, like I used to go to a black church, man. And like the good black preacher used to say, what he used to say. He just used to say what he needed to say. He said, breakthrough, 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 man. Breakthrough! And then the people in the audience will start to break through a little bit. Of course, so I learned a little something from the black preacher, man. How to break the flock through with your international peaceful words of Gandhi that really said, all right, quit sitting around talking about it and be the fucking change you want to see, brothers and sisters. Just be it. You know, basically says, you know, stop all the hanky-panky bullshit and just be the change you want to see. And that takes practice. It's hard to get past all the peer pressure of being this way and you gotta be that way and all the frequencies and shit that they shoot at you. But you have to be the change and set your male thoughts into motion that's gonna cause everything in the manifested physical realm to manifest the change. And sometimes you gotta take a little break because it's a little hard to manifest thoughts into the present moment of the reality of sitting in the backyard with your good stuff while you can be silent and look at all your thoughts and match them up to the signs of nature. It takes practice to be able to have time. It takes motivation to break away and have time to yourself. Yeah. Time to yourself, or if you have others around you have to care for, like I have four cats, me and my four cats sit around and we all meditate in the backyard together. If you ever wanted to learn how to meditate, all you gotta do is study the cat, and you learn something about being a commissioned warrant officer of military status. Coming up here 2 more years, it will be my 30-year mark, eligible for full bonded retirement. And I keep my stuff to myself, unless I feel like sharing it to you. I just happen to feel like sharing a little something with you. You understand who you are. Yeah, I went into the military in 1986, the Navy, on the flight deck, USS Nimitz. And yes, we did win the Battle E. For some reason, the universe decided that the Battle E was to go to that ship during my reign on the flight deck. And all I did was just have to be there and be who I was. That was it. And I was just a young little 18-year-old, 22-year-old, young kid boy. didn't have an inkling about really what life was, except for everything that was naturally in me to do what I just naturally do with my shy ass self that I was back then. Ain't like I am today, man. I'm all up in your YouTube face today. Thank God for frickin' YouTube that we can get on there and practice unreleasing and getting those repressed emotions all out there so we can deal with them. Lay all the cards on the table like Ken Robert. Ken Robert, the gambler, used to say, you gotta know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, know when to run. You no need to count your money while you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. So, I do my own little live Tesla radio wave frequency programs out in my backyard. I call it Russell Radio 88.8 AM. Using the latest and greatest Tesla radio wave frequencies, just like Jay the Juice Man Juicer. It's live, it ain't no dead, and we got some wild beat planted in the backyard. The cats lick it up. Wild ass beat. You want to learn how to get down with your clown, you might want to swing by the bike path behind my residential place that I hold title to. And you can see right into my backyard where I am at and what I'm doing, and listen in if you need to. If you know where I'm at, all you gotta do is scope out my private public backyard access. I have an open gate. You can see right into my backyard. All the public passes by my house as I do my radio public program and keep my neighbors informed on my street and the village that I shaman. Damn straight. I don't play around. I handle things. So, and I had one neighbor complain whatsoever. Because I always go around to my neighbors and I say, am I being too loud? Am I being this? How am I doing? Is basically the question. I learned that from Pizza Hut. You always ask. You always ask when you're managing a shift, you ask the employees, how am I doing? How am I doing? Where can I improve? What can I do to make things better, more pleasant? How am I doing? And the customer's always right and satisfied. No matter if he's wrong or right, he's always right. You give that customer what he wants. If you have to, you go to the store and you buy him a bag of M&M's and send him with the delivery boy and give him M&M's on the house. You treat that customer like he is your best frickin' mother friend. That's where you start learning how to get down with your clown, getting real with yourself. How am I doing? And you encourage the customer to say, tell me really how you feel. Just like if you're a black man sitting up at the church, tell me really how you feel, how I'm doing. What can I, where can I use my improvements? See what I'm saying? How am I doing? How am I doing? How am I doing? Am I speaking some truth or what? Is there anyone out here that has any agreement with what I have to say?
And if no one agrees and no one say anything, you might want to change the degree.
Swoop in from a different angle till you find a point of commonality and agreement. Because that's the law of attraction, brothers and sisters. Looking for what's common and appreciating the unity of something. There's always even the smallest little bit of particle. When everything outside of it is negative, that smallest little bit of positive common particle between everybody is just enough to connect everyone and find the unity of peace on an international peace level. when you do your secured creditor party stuff, you realize that that is an international peace treaty standing at the highest international military level. And you are a commission warrant officer with all the power of leaning in trust, with all the backing of Mother Nature and Father Cosmos. When you learn how to attract to you in your life the things that you want to see manifested through the power of your male side, which is your sitting in the backyard meditating deep in thought. Thank God for marijuana laws is passed here in the state that I live in. Yeah, this year it was Oregon, Washington, D.C., and Alaska, all three in a line. That'll tell you the federal jurisdiction of Obama, who knows what he's doing in the states of the people he's picked out to represent. I ain't no clown that's been around the track one time. I've been there. Passed many a test. Knocks at the door, letters in the mail, scare tactics here, scare tactics there. I seen all the signs. And I addressed each and every corporate detail, down to the banks, to the state, to the IRS, to the county, in all realms of debt, liability, and taxation. Standing firm as a commission warrant officer. Now, there's four levels of commission warrant officer, so you got to be real with yourself as to what level you're at. For me, I'm a CWO2 or CWO3. There's CWO4, 03, 02, and 01. As soon as I get my international banking rules under my belt, and I have at my command full access to the unlimited account, I will be a CWO2. And then when I learn how to progress in that professionally on an international scaled level, I will be a CWO1. I know who I am. I know the position that I hold. The world, the earth, the universe we live in is a cat military world. If you have eyes to see it and ears to hear, that the dude Jesus was trying to get around everybody, that you have the capacity to all walk at the same level of capstone wisdom, skill, and understanding, walking side by side. And all the information of moving up the pyramid is already publicly known on YouTube. There ain't no more secrets. There's nothing to hide anymore. The education level is laid out. And if you're being real with yourself, you realize you're at the bottom of the pyramid at working a assumed slave employee job position. And if you want to move up, well, just type in solutions and commerce in the YouTube search and listen to a aged man hearing it from one voice give you motivation to maybe call up his office and say, hey, I only got this amount of money. Can you send me some seminars so I can read and hear it for myself from front to back instead of little parts here and little parts there? And then when you get some teachings under your belt, get about 10 seminars under your belt, as well as some of the single DVDs, especially the Lean, Commercial Lean DVD, and the A for V, Paul Zicardi knowledge. Give you a little clue about promissory notes and writing your own banking instruments to get things done when you see fit. For me, I had to see my lean position stand and hold before I'm going to start getting into promissory notes. And as far as I can tell right now, I am standing and holding. Because there is no property tax assessor or judge judgment against my ass. The lean position I hold on the straw man of this body, none. They sent all kinds of letters in the mail, and I saw right through it. It's just process. That's all it is. It's scare tactic process. For the lower guys at the lower level who don't know about what what's really going on at the DOJ level. Yes, President Obama is a DOJ level attorney. He knows exactly what's going on with the birth certificate, and that's why he brought the subject up. If you have eyes to hear and ears to see. So, that might be a little hard, but that's kind of like my female side. The female side is always impulsive and instinctive and just speaks first and thinks later, and then makes adjustments for the next speech. See how that works? Till such as time, you know, if he's in that I'm in, or that person or real man might be in his own backyard at full peace capacity instead of having to utilize what's called the library system. Nothing wrong with using it. If you want to see your lean position stand, shut off all umbilical cords. If that's what you want to do, it's all your option. I'm just saying that's what I had to do because I wanted to see that lean stand for myself. Not paying for anything. Because I knew in my heart that that lean holds significance at an international level. I knew it. I just wanted to experience standing in it, and I am standing firm in it, and I'm going to stand a little more time with it. I'm going to feel it out as it goes. You see what I'm saying? Someone's over there playing some guitar in the library at the end of the courtyard. But anyway, let's listen to another Black Sabbath song called Disturbing the Priest. So we'll listen to another song, and then maybe that will be all I need to get on the record. I just wanted to share a piece of my mind. That's what the female side of us likes to do. Likes to give a piece of our mind, and then we reevaluate and think about it later. Like, there it is. This is Black Sabbath, Born Again, the song called Disturbing the Priest.
I just gotta listen to the night and the self-stand slips away. So unreal, unreal. You just gotta listen to your mind and say your prayers. No time singers sing and rectifies lies. Come to my feast. Disturbing the priest.
Head turned up a little bit, getting carried away a little bit. We're gonna have to get Michael Sweet on some of those Ian Gillan high screams. Get a chance to listen to that Black Sabbath Born Again album, brothers and sisters. That is one passionate, filled record. it in the public too.
Side and side, there's no thing down goes away. It's just like the battle of the morn and the moon and night and day.
And it gets too near.
Disturbing the priest. Won't you come to my feast? Disturbing the priest. In life is contradiction. You need the crucifixion. When your life is all in the hell.
Don't mind me while I get beside myself a little bit here in the public library. City Hall courtyard on a Saturday. Just a few customers processing by.
Hang on, what are you gonna die?
I'll put the link in the description.
Disturbing the priest.
And that's the baby crying at the end of the song. When you get in touch with those repressed emotions and let out what's deep within that larynx. Alright, this is Brother Russell signing out for today's